Now that we know how to create HTML pages, let's see some coding in action. An HTML element usually consists of a start tag and an end tag, with the content inserted in between. The HTML element is everything from the start tag to the end tag. For example, the HTMLP element defines a paragraph. So if you want a paragraph on your page, write the P start tag, add content inside, and close it with the /P end tag. This is now a HTMLP element, also known as a paragraph element. All HTML documents consist of nested HTML elements. Nested elements are elements within elements. For instance, these two elements are nested within the body element, which in turn is nested within the HTML element. Let's take a closer look at the different elements. First, the HTML element defines the HTML document. It comes with a start tag and an end tag. Inside the HTML element, we have the body element, which defines the document body. It comes with a start tag and an end tag. The body element contains two other HTML elements. The first one defines a heading with the text "My first heading." The second one defines a paragraph with the text "My first paragraph." Remember to always include the end tag. It might work without it, but there's always a chance it will produce unexpected results or errors. However, some HTML elements do not have content. They're called empty elements and do not have end tags. An example of this is the BR element, which is an element with no content. It just defines a line break. HTML tags are not case sensitive. Both lowercase and uppercase works and means the same thing. However, it is recommended to use lowercase tags. And with that said, we've covered the basics of HTML elements and how to use them.